you stumble a little bit and you we've seen what can happen. Columbus losing their coach, of course, they got off to a terrible start, but not a lot of patience for coaches anymore.
Chance in front of Poso, save, rebound bounces around, chipped to the boards by Marchand.
Strong start for the Islanders, plus four already over the first six games, and he appears to have no residual effects from that knee injury that he suffered during the playoffs or before the playoff foot.
Not at all. In fact, Howie, he's about 10 pounds lighter, and the same, maybe a little baby fat. He probably wouldn't like that expression.
Here's Marchand. That's why they invented pizza. Throwing it back to Krug. He shoots, and a glove save is made by Halak. Already tied for fourth in the league in penalty minutes.
Yeah, lucky not to get suspended the other night with his hit on Couture of the Flyers. Couturier, excuse me.
Butterbuck a shot, and that's held by Gustafsson.
Nelson, they've been skating so well, and Grabowski, how he is playing center, and his position he likes more than any other. He's been very good with it, with his speed.
DeHaan turned it over. In comes Eriksson. Shoots. Halak slides over to make the save by Boychuk. Back in the Islanders' zone. Bruins changing on the move. Boychuk faked the shot that froze the Bruins for a moment. So now he takes it in behind the net. Put it out in front. Lee took a bump as he was trying to get that fluttering puck to the net. Couldn't do it. His ascension to the Islander coaching job. He is the fourth longest tenured coach in the league. And you can believe that. Connolly a drive, he scores! Brett Connolly just jumps on a
quick little pass, just a loose one out in front there, and goes past John Tavares. Connolly picks up the loose puck. Bergeron wins the battle in the corner, and then it's the pass from Louis Erickson.
Over 100 minutes, 131 seconds to be exact. 9:51, the time of the goal, second of the year for Connolly, and Boston strikes first. But they don't clear. Bailey turns and shoots. And that's steered away by Gustafsson. And Miller takes it back. Marchand and Bergeron draw the assists on Connolly's goal. Sharp angle shot by Hayes is stopped. Zedlitsky's one-timer knocked away. And it's six to go to the power play. Bruins get it back. They could have a two-on-one here. Eriksson with Kelly. Eriksson closes in. Eriksson in the backhand. Halak slid out. Nice play by Halak. Up over the Boston line. Put a move on. Now holds up. Has some room. Steps up. Shoots the save. Rebound. Score! Josh Bailey ties it on the power play. 1-1.
Big save on Eriksson. The Islanders go the other way. There's the rebound. Bailey was kind of on his knees off balance, but finds a way to dig it out, just like he was in a six-inch rough at the Masters.
Hamonen works it down the right wing boards. Morrow and Martin came together vigorously, and Cizikas with a big hit with Krejci, or pardon me, Miller behind the net. Letty kicked away by Morrow.
Slap shot, Howie, so he can shoot the puck.
Boychuk played it in front. They score! Cizikas! Casey Cizikas gives the Islanders a 2-1 lead, but now Matt Martin and Adam McQuaid are looking to go.
Interval that the fourth line, the EMC squared line, went to work. Boychuk in front of the net to a Casey Cizikas. Opportunity to be in the World Series.
It's been fabulous. The World Series begins on Tuesday night. Just don't know where yet. I told John Tavares before the game this could get personal. JT is a huge Toronto Blue Jays fan. On Tavares. Put it off the skate of Oposo, but all the way to Zedlitsky.
Kyle Oposo in the slot. That's a change for this year's power play, having Kyle in that slot area.
And is Lee off to the side to Oposo? And it was stopped by Gustafsson. About a half dozen teams have moved their operations in the American League out to California now.
Yeah, the West Coast teams in particular.
Letty, nice rush in for a shot. And that's steered away by Gustafsson.
Certainly not comparing Letty with Orr, but that was Orr-like speed as he zipped around the defenseman.
If you saw Bobby Orr play and you see a defenseman make a rush like that, Boychuk shot steered away and out of play. Played back by Ronaldo and through a screen he fires over the net. Krejci doing most of the screen work in front. And Ronaldo kept it in. Sharp angle shot that went off the arm of Halak and then the net is dislodged. Marchand couldn't reach it. Hayes takes off to the corner though. Hayes to Marchand. Put it right through the slot all the way to the blue line. Morrow a drive, redirects, and Halak reacted and made a nice save. Bergeron draws against Nielsen. Marchand scoots to the corner. Brad Marchand got it to the net and a save by Halak.
Toss are always a challenge, an important part of the game.
Bergeron across, fed down low, too far for Connolly. And up comes Nielsen. Hans Nielsen shooting and a glove save made by Gustafsson. Set out by Miller, recovered by Leddy. Sidesteps a Ronaldo hit. And now Leddy on the rush. In over the line, a drop to Martin, tees it up, shoots up high, and a save by Gustafsson. Now Randell drops it back from Morrow. He missed by a healthy margin. Bergeron against Strom. Nice drop. Quick shot. Love save. Marchand took the shot. Leddy makes a return, or Nelson does, from Grabowski. And he took a bump. Didn't seem to mind it. Krug to Bergeron. Save made. Rebound from the second trailer is Krug. And he is robbed by Halak. Matt Martin along the near board. Scoops it out of the zone. Scott Gordon coaching. Thank you, Eric. Hornick for the Lehigh Valley Phantoms, Flyers American League affiliates, are 22-14 Islanders. It was 18-8 New York at the end of one. Miller's drive, tip, stop, rebound, Marchand, fluttering puck, and that gave Halak time to get over.
1-on-1 hockey in today's game.
Gahan didn't get it out. Spooner's shot is blocked. Rebound, score! And that block was made by Hamonic, who, if he's not hurt, appeared shaken at first.
It out is knocked down by Spooner, and Kampainen just goes to the net with a fortuitous bounce and makes absolutely no mistake. And that's what they're expecting from the big guy, 6'4" Finn. Halak's not able to get over and establish.
Shot deflect.
Bruins are winning all the battles.
McQuaid got one through there. And now Pasternak scores! And the Bruins, as Butchie just said, winning all those one-on-one battles.
Look at the Bruins go to work. They're winning those battles. Quick shot. And then Gahan just clears it in the middle of the ice and then doesn't come out quick enough and close the gap instead of going right out, in my opinion. Never worry about blocking the shot. Let your goaltender do that.
They're in the second, and they've been getting better and better as this period's worn on.
They really sort of warmed to the task. And it's been a simple game for them, which is what the Bruins do so well.
Turnover, Cizikas denied by an aggressive Gustafsson. He's back to Krug. He fires and misses the net. You're telling me now there's 30 seconds left as it mysteriously reappears.
Hayes in front of the net providing a terrible screen for Halak. Terrible in the fact that he can't see it.
Halak just managed to get an arm on that one.
Klein.
Garth Snow showed faith in his club by keeping things pretty well the same.
Yeah, for a number of years when everybody was calling for his head and the players' heads.
Sharp angle shot stopped by Halak. Leaps it ahead towards Krejci. Nielsen back to get it. Now at the far side, McQuaid had the stick knocked out of his hands.
Miller was decked by Kyle Oposo. Excuse me, it was Pasternak decked by Kyle Oposo.
Loose puck, Bailey chips it.
Smith to Florida. That's almost 170 points, Howie, they had to replace.
Boychuk's first drive block got another chance to feed in front to Lee. A wraparound is sticked aside and protected by Gustafsson. The Bruins 18-8. Their shots advantage is now 24-23. So they've only had, there's a chance in front. They score. Kampainen was at the side of the net. I don't think he deflected it.
Give and go, the back pass, and that goes in. Off of Zydlitsky, I believe it is, down low in front of the net.
Off one skate.
Yeah, off both skates, off the right toe, then the left skate.
The Bruins have been a difficult team to come back against late in the game because of the way they just bottle up the middle of the ice. And here they come offensively with Bergeron snapping one off of Hamonic. Wrap around by Kelly. Got a piece of 2.5 remaining. McQuaid up for Erickson. A drop to Krejci. He hits the open net. David Krejci with 2:25 to go in the third has given the Bruins a 5-2 lead.
A very poor breakout by the Islanders. A couple of times they turned it over. That's an area that they're going to have to spend a little more time, check some video out just to be a little bit more creative on the coming out of their own zone. Travis Ryan Strome taking a little look over to Franz Nielsen. Again, the turnover, and then the Bruins all standing in the neutral zone. Thinking the coaches will anyway about St. Louis. Goaltender, will it be Thomas Greiss?
Hickey scores! Hickey lets go a drive from above the circle. And some of those people may turn around and come right back to their seats.
Oh, wait a minute, I might have to pull my goalie again now because I'm within two again. Thomas Hickey with the good shot, snapped it off his stick. Gustafson got trapped in the net, went down, went right over his glove. Good play by Casey Cizikas, though, to drive through the middle of the ice. He took a check. Thomas Hickey ends up with the puck, scores goals in back-to-back games. One of the last time he did that. There's the move by Clutterbuck, and then Hickey gets it back to Thomas Hickey. That's really a terrific move.
Brooklyn with a 5-3 win over the New York Islanders.
And you wonder if Cappy will make some changes now.